Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be doing like a fall inspired, like a deep grungier look since, you know, fall just started, but in North Carolina it's still like 85 degrees. So I decided to play around with some makeup today. But before we get started, make sure to click that subscribe button down below and give this video a thumbs up. And when I reach 100 subscribers, I'm going to be doing a giveaway. So just keep that in mind. Make sure to tell your friends about me because you might get a little something good. I don't know what you're going to get yet, but I'm going to get you something. So let's just jump in. Okay, first off, we'll be using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. And I think this is something good for fall because your makeup in the fall is a lot heavier, I will say. And unlike summer, like where you just wear like a BB cream and kind of go on. So this fills in your pores and kind of blurs your skin. So that way you don't see all of those. Like, I don't know, I have bad texture on my face. So this stuff really helps me. Okay, next off, this is something that I've recently fell in love with. And at first I really didn't like it that much because you still saw my freckles through, and I don't know, I'm just not somebody that, if I have a foundation, I either won't own it full coverage, like, I don't want to see anything. But this one has grown on me. Plus, it makes your skin feel very soft to the touch, and it helps, like, I'm really sensitive skinned, and it helps me, because I don't break out from this. So I just take about 2 pumps on my wrist. I'm just going to put that on my face. And I want to put all this foundation, like, cover your face all at one time, like, with little dots. Because it dries kind of fast. And you don't, and then it makes it harder for things to blend in. And nobody wants that. This foundation also gives your face, like, a natural, like, dewiness that I really like. At first, I was against it because I liked everything to be very matte, but I like to look alive, so. If there's any products that y'all want me to try, make sure to comment them, because, I mean, I'm only in college, and I'm a waitress, so I don't make much, but I always try to get my hands on everything, like, new that's coming out. Just because, for one, I like having makeup and I like trying new things. But I know that's probably what y'all like too. So, we're done with this. And now we're going to pick up my Tarte Shape Tape. And this is in the color Light. This was in the color 710 Classic Ivory. And that's the lightest they have. And I'll be honest, it oxidizes and I could have gone a shade lighter. But they didn't. So I'm almost out of this, y'all, which is very sad. Probably because I use so much every single day. If anybody's looking for a good concealer, you need to go out and get this. Alright, now you can thank me later in the comments down below. Okay, now we're going to put it on our forehead. I just like the highlights everywhere. I just love concealer, to be honest. Now we're going to blend this in with my beauty blender. And I always bring it down the bridge of my nose because sometimes, like, I'll contour the sides of my nose just, like, ever so slightly. And I feel like if you put brightening stuff on it, it helps when you go to contour. But I don't know if y'all follow her, but she's my favorite YouTuber of all time, and she's kind of the reason I started making my channel, because she made a video about how when the right time to start a YouTube channel was, and she was like, the right time is now. And so when I watched that video, I had this little black tiny little vanity in the corner of my room, and I made a video. But, I mean, I deleted it because, first off, the quality was horrific. And I didn't have my MacBook, so I couldn't edit it. And when I tried to upload it off my phone, it wouldn't upload. So. But her name's Laurely, and I'm really proud of her because she just made her first palette. It's called Cat Pajamas. And yes, weird name, but she loves cats just like me. And I'm really excited to get that. And that's coming out on Friday the 13th. And so y'all really need to check that out because I'm sure it'll be great quality. All right. Now we're going to take my favorite, the Airspun. This is the reason I don't like it though. Did y'all see this? Like, it gets everywhere. It'll be on my shirt by the time I'm finished with this video. Now I'm just gonna set everything into place. I'm just trying to put something out there because I've been kind of MIA lately, and I'm sorry. But I'm taking economics this semester and biology. And yeah, that was not a smart idea because they're kicking my butt. And I have a biology test tomorrow. But I'm sad I'm over here and playing with makeup. I've already studied, so it's okay. Okay, and I'm not really gonna bake that heavy. So I'm gonna go ahead and wipe that away and kind of blend it in with my foundation. Alright, next up we're gonna take my MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. And what I like to do is I take my finger and I just spin it around and I put it on my eyes. And this stuff is the best money I've ever spent. It was kind of expensive, but it lasts for a really long time. Alright, now I'm going to take my e.l.f. highlighting brush and I'll go back in my Cuddy Airspun. I'm just going to get some of this, tap it, and I can set my eyes. Alright, and now y'all know what Madison Cole's going to use. I'm going to use my Morphe and Jaclyn Hill palette. Now we're going to take my Sculpt blending brush and we're going to go into this first color right here. Well, it's not the first color, but it's the third. It's the first color I always use. Tap off our brush and blend it in. This is a really good transition color, but it's because it's not your skin tone. It's a little lighter than my skin tone, and it just makes everything blend like a dream. I do put this on. I have a lot of no video ideas. It's just like sitting down and doing them, which is really hard with my schedule and everything with working and school and trying to do YouTube. But I really want to do a video where either Hunter or my dad do a voiceover of what they think my makeup is, because Hunter thinks that anything on my cheeks is contour. It's really cute, but I'm just like, no, Shug, this is blush. It's okay. And he says it's so funny. He's like, contour? He's gonna watch this and he knows I'm joking on him. Alright, now we're going to go in with my Morphe 518. This is another great affordable brush. Like, you need to get Morphe brushes now. I need to get another shipment in because I only have like 3, but they're the best brushes ever. Shipping's just kind of outrageous. Alright, now I'm going to go in with the fourth color right here. And get some on it. Tap it off. We're going to focus this, all these colors, and just in our crease, like building it up darker. So now I'm going to go, well, it's just right there, and now we're going down one to right here. I think this is a shade. Her name, she named it Peaky. And I love this color for my transition shades. It's like one palette that has everything you need. And if y'all would comment down below if y'all like where I'm sitting now, or like when I or if you like sit when I was sitting at my desk, knowing some feedback sometimes, because sometimes it feels like I have nobody talking to me, and I'm just talking, sitting in my, like a 18-year-old sitting in her room, talking to her camera, and I feel stupid. And sometimes it's just nice to know that. Y'all do appreciate what I do. But now we're gonna go down one more color to right here. All right, and the darker color we go, the more we make sure to focus it in the crease. Like, we don't, because, like, when the first color you get, it's okay to, like, get it, like, closer to your eyebrow. But, like, with these shades, like, the lower you go, you need to make sure it's in your crease. Because you do not want black by your eyebrow. That's not cute. Alright, now we're going from this shade right here to this one right here, just so I can see. We're going like deeper into the browns since it is fall. It's going to be like a kind of a reddish brownish thing because, like, you know, I think of the fall wheat. Oh my gosh, I cannot talk. I think of the fall leaves falling, like the reds and the browns and the leaves. I'm so ready for fall, y'all. You just don't even know. I'm ready to bring out my Uggs and wear Bing boots, and I've already bought big scarves for this year. Like, that's how excited I am for fall. And it's not even cold outside. I'm kind of putting this in my outer corner some too, just to start deepening that up. And I can't talk into eyeshadow, so that's why I pause every 5 seconds to talk to y'all. Okay, so now we went from here, and now we're going down to this brown. And we're going to mix this one and this one, so. And I'm really going to focus that more on the outside edge. If y'all hear a TV, that's where my dad's downstairs. Welcome to the Parish House. Okay, now we're just going to blend everything together with this brush to make sure there's no harsh edges. Alright, so now I'm going to take my Glamour Dolls brush that I got in my Ipsy bag, and we're going to go in with this black shade right here before this one. I've really thought about ordering the new Natasha Denona palette, but y'all, that's expensive. If y'all don't know how much Natasha Denona is, it's like $120. Yeah. And so, that's how much I'm making a week waitressing. And I don't know why I want the daggone thing. But I do. Of course, Madison does. Okay, so now I'm going to give y'all kind of a close-up of my... So now you can see that dark, and you can see how it blends from here and goes up, like, into lighter colors. That's what your eyeshadow should be looking like right about now. Now we're going to take my Sephora Pro brush, the Pro 19, and I kind of want to incorporate a little bit of red. So this is kind of like a pointed tip. And I'm going to go in with this shade right here. Tap it off. Put it right there in the crease. Okay, so I have decided that I'm going to use this color right here. And I'm going to try it with my finger first. So I'm just going to swatch it around. I'm going to go in with this brush one more time. This is my 441 brush. Blend out those edges. Now we're going to go in on my lower lash line. And I'm going to use the Royal and Lane Nickel, the shader brush. Blend that off just a tiddly bit. And we're going to go in with the color right here, which is called Pukey. That one just sticks in my head, y'all. The other day, I had a lady, and I really hope she's watching this video because this would be so cool. But I was at TJ Maxx, and she I don't know how it came up, but we were talking about makeup, and then I told her about my YouTube channel. So, I really hope she's watching this, because that would mean she's a real OG, and she came and watched my videos. Okie dokie. I'm done with that palette. I think. Maybe. Probably not. Now I'm going to use my Cheek Parade, and I'm going to go in with Hoola Light. Did y'all see this? This is how much I love this. I use this, I don't even care, like, if I don't even have any makeup on, normally I'll just, like, use some of it. And I'm using this Sonia Kenesha brush, and I'm going to bronze up my face, but not too much. This is going to be a more contoured look, but I still like putting just a little bit of bronzer on. I'm going to tell y'all about this real fast. So, when I was at TJ Maxx the other day, that's kind of my addiction right now, is TJ Maxx. Until Sephora comes, then TJ Maxx will be kicked to the side, because Sephora is coming to Goldsboro, y'all. Mark your calendars. I don't know what day it is, but it's coming. And I'm very excited. But, anyway, I found this, and I put it on my Snapchat, and all these people were, like, messaging me, like, oh my goodness. I got this. It's called the Kat Von D Shade and Light. And the only reason it was in there is because Kat Von D is changing their packaging to this. But shoot, I'm okay with this little, I think they're adding like a clasp probably to it, so it's just not like flinging all around. But I'm fine with this. It ain't like I'm traveling anywhere. I mean, my makeup stays in my vanity. The only way it travels is right here to this little disc. So we're going to use this lightest shade right here. We're just going to tap in it. And this is a Real Techniques brush, the contour brush. We're going to contour. Making sure to like really get in your cheekbones, so that way you look like you can already tell the difference from this shape to this shape. I have the Too Faced like contour kit, but I really don't like that. I don't ever use it. And I'll put a little bit on my forehead. Alrighty, now I'm going to take my Tarte blush and party. You have to say it like that because that's how it's spelled, sorry. And I'm just going to use this Luxie 660 brush. It's a foundation brush, but Madison uses this blush. Because it like really like fits my cheekbones. It's perfect. And we're not trying to make it too blushy, but this is kind of like a... This is a good blush for the look I'm going for. First off, I'm going to take my Real Techniques accent brush. It's very tiny. And I'm going to take the first shade right here. I think it's called In Light. And I'm just going to pop that. Alright, and now everybody knows what Madison uses for her upper brow. I use my Cupcake little tiny brush. I got this from Claire's, and I think when I was like 8. And I'm going to go in that same color. And I just kind of go from my arch of my brow over. And then I blend it in afterwards. We are going to do my favorite thing. Highlighter. And I'm going to use the Ofra highlighter in Rodeo Drop. Just look how pretty this is. Like, that's gorgeous. You just can't beat it. And I'm going to use the Morphe 501 brush. Put some, kind of tap off the excess. And glow. Oh, so pretty. A little bit on my eyes. I kind of like putting some over here too. And on my chin, okay. Because now we are going to be using, I got this in my Ipsy too. I get a lot of stuff in my Ipsy, and you need to go check out that video, because then you'll kind of understand like where I get all my stuff from. But this is a Cougar 24 hour lipstick, and you can see it's like this really deep color, and I feel like that will go perfect with our look for today. So, and this lipstick really is 24 hours. Like, it's not joking. Okay, so that is, I'll give y'all kind of a close up of my eye look. But this is my fall inspired makeup look. And if you have any questions about this or like me to do anything like another video like this, make sure to leave a comment down below so I can know exactly what y'all want to see each week. But yeah, thank y'all so much for watching. I'll see y'all later. Bye.